The following is a blog post by Bruce Gagnon, the coordinator of an organization called the Global Network Against Weapons and Nuclear Power in Space. It was so good that I wanted to make a video out of it. Explain to future generations it was good for the economy when they can't farm the land, breathe the air, or drink the water. Parents and grandparents could explain to their children, "I'm sorry, I had to play tennis when there were protests. I don't like to get involved in controversial politics. You can't beat City Hall, why bother? I might lose my job if I get involved with those groups. I might get my name on some FBI list if I went to those meetings. What would my friends and family think of me if I worked with people like you? I've got better things to do with my money than donate to one of those causes. We are all going to die anyway, so why bother? Don't worry, be happy. I'm not that smart, and those in government seem to know what they are doing anyway. I heard on NPR that everything is going to be okay. Think of all the jobs we get from these industries. You people just want to shut everything down. I wanted to help, but I had to put 3 kids through college. My spouse threatened to leave me if I went to one of those meetings. These things didn't directly impact me or my family. I'm sorry, but I'm a capitalist and I support this system. Look what it has done for me. This system is about freedom first and foremost. Should we all just live in caves? I read the New York Times every day, so I know what is going on. In one way or the other, I've heard just about all of these excuses during my time as a full-time social justice, peace, and environmental organizer since 1978. Most people find one or more reasons from the list above to justify spending their lives in denial of the apparent reality. The techno world and capitalism has transformed many people into automatons. It's very sad, but a fact of our time. The goal would be that people would rediscover their spiritual connection to our Mother Earth and one another before it is too late. It might be a bit romantic on my part, but I often think about all those in my long family lineage who got our relations through the ice ages, droughts, famines, plagues, wars, and the like. Now, during this moment on Earth, some are giving up the ghost. I can't understand why anyone would surrender when our number one job as a human being is to protect our children and the planet. Both are the future. It's a broken spiritual connection that we all suffer from that keeps us locked in our prison. Best wishes in the new year.